Today I'm going to tell you about how Italy became a country. The unification of Italy, also known as Risorgimento, was the 19th century movement that reunited a number of independent Italian states into a single kingdom of Italy. Let's start at the beginning. After the fall of the Western Roman Empire, Italy fragmented into a number of independent city-states, governed by a number of foreign countries. The Italian aspiration was to return Italy to a single entity along the lines of Roman Empire. Charles VIII of France attacked Naples, and this began the Italian War of 1494. This involved Spain, France, the Holy Roman Empire, and the Pope. Leading Italian Renaissance writers such as Dante, Petrarch, Boccaccio, Machiavelli, and Guicciardini railed against the foreign occupiers of Italy. The French Revolution of 1789 spread new ideas in a wave of violence. The French Revolutionary Wars were fought across northern Italy between the French Revolutionary Army, Austria, Russia, Piedmont, Sardinia, and the Italian city-states. This period flooded Italy with new ideas on republicanism, citizenship, and challenged traditional attitudes regarding feudalism and power, and stoked demands for Italian reunification.
To learn more about La Bella Italia, consider subscribing.
Napoleon installed rulers in French-supported states, such as Eugene Beauharnais, Viceroy of the Italian Republic in 1805, and Joachim Murat, King of Naples in 1808. As Napoleon was defeated during the Congress of Vienna of 1815, Austria, Britain, France, Russia, and Prussia agreed a long-term European-wide peace settlement, which restored pre-Napoleonic European powers and monarchies. This meant Italy was again largely governed by the Austrian Empire, the Habsburgs, and the Pope. De Beauharnais sought Austrian approval to keep his position in the new Kingdom of Italy. Murat issued the failed Rimini Proclamation, calling upon Italians to fight against Austria for Italian independence. The Carbonari were a secret pro-revolutionary group which spread across southern Italy. A failed uprising led by Guglielmo Pepe in 1820 was unable to force Ferdinand I to accept a new constitution which would restrict his power. Nor did Santore di Santa Rosa in Alessandria in 1821. In 1830, there were independent Italian states with separate laws and traditions and no common language. Key leaders and writers like Ugo Foscolo and Gabriele Rossetti lived and plotted in exile. These expats learnt new ways of thinking which would shape the future unified Italy. There were broadly two realistic models for a unified Italy: a federal republic, no monarchy, and the state controlled the church, or a compromise position of a confederation of Italian separate states led by a Piedmont monarchy. The French king Louis-Philippe I, and not for the last time, reneged on promises made to revolutionaries like Ciro Menotti, and as a result the Modena revolt of 1831 failed. Menotti was executed and became a martyr. Mazzini spent his long incarceration planning for a free, independent, republican Italy with its capital in Rome. Garibaldi, a former citizen of Nice, fled to exile in South America. Insurrections broke out in the papal legations. This included Bologna, Ferrara, Ravenna, Fodli, Ancona, and Perugia, and these briefly claimed to be part of a wider Italian nation. Province Italiane Unite. Pope Gregory XVI sought Austrian military support to reassert control across the papal legations. In 1844, the Bandiera brothers attempted an uprising in Crotone, but they were betrayed and executed by a firing squad shouting Viva Italia, long live Italy. The song Inno di Mameli was first performed in 1847 and would later become the Italian national anthem. In 1848, rulers were beginning to experience the constraints of these new constitutions, which limited their power. Pope Pius IX reluctantly agreed a constitution after an uprising by the Romans. There was a short-lived Roman Republic led by Mazzini in 1849, and at the same time Ruggero VII briefly led an independent Sicily. The people of Milan ejected the Austrian garrison of Marshal Joseph Radetzky during the 5 days of street fighting, known as Cinque Giornate di Milano. Charles Albert, the King of Sardinia, Piedmont, declared war on Austria, supporting Venice and Milan. This was the first Italian War of Independence. Piedmont was defeated at the Battle of Custoza. A broken Charles Albert of Piedmont abdicated in favour of his son, Victor Emmanuel II. Charles Oudinot led a French force determined to guarantee the power of the Pope in Rome in 1849. Rome fell, the Pope was reinstated, Garibaldi and Mazzini fled into exile, the Austrians overwhelmed Venice's volunteer army led by Daniele Manin and Guglielmo Pepe in 1848-49. The Austrians reasserted control. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, perhaps you might consider giving it a like so other people can see it. Click here for some more videos you may be interested in.